Hey everybody, CPO from Maybe I'm Amazed, back with my friend Antoine Arvisu from the Compound Studio here in Long Beach. And today we're listening to Sand Fairy Anne off the Wings at the Speed of Sound album. Once again, Sand Fairy Anne. Let's check it out, guys.
Here we go.
You've got a lot, and from what you've got, I'd say you're doing well, dear. Dressed like a dream, and if things are what they seem, you're looking swell, dear.
One, huh?
Yeah.
Two minutes.
208. Yeah. Sand Fairy Anne.
Back to Paul singing.
That kind of remind you of, I don't know, this is, it struck me as like the Buena Vista Social Club type of, maybe, I mean, it reminded me of
New Orleans thing to me.
Oh, okay.
I was thinking New Orleans.
I was thinking like Cuban.
With those horns.
Salsa.
Yeah. I think he's got a little Cuban going on in this album in general. Yeah. And another thing that struck me was how, because he's making an album, and it seems like these days, mm-hmm. I'm not want to speak for everybody, but, you know, people put out a bunch of singles, so each song's a hit. Song's like, we're going for it. This is going to be the big seller.
Yeah.
Whereas you're making an album, Paul knows he's got Silly Love Songs and Let Him In that, you know, start the two. I've got my hits.
Yeah.
People are going to buy the record.
Yeah.
So I can put some interesting little two-minute tidbits, which mm-hmm. someone might call it filler. But it gives the ear some, you know, rest, and I think it's a great song. I will always remember this one. Again, I haven't listened to this record a lot since I was a young person. Every now and then it might come out, but I listened to the heck out of this when I was, you know, in my 20s maybe.
Right.
And that song, I always just get a kick out of it.
You know?
And who knows if it ever would have come out in today's age of, you know, singles, the next single.
Yeah. Who knows? Yeah. Sand Fairy Anne. I wonder what it's about.
It's probably about...
I mean, Sand Fairy...
It's probably about some person he met on a ferry.
Yeah.
And decided to make a little...
Or a place called Sand Fairy.
There you go. Someone!
So where
who
is,
knows?
Where is Sand Fairy?
Where is Sand Fairy?
I bet that Sand Fairy is in a place where music kind of sounds like this.
There was a woman named Anne that he met.
Some girl named Anne.
Dressed like a dream.
Yeah.
You're looking swell, dear. The horns sound great. And Joe English drumming, again, you know what I mean? Not just a rock drummer. He's got this interesting little brushes thing going on. Kind of remind me of like a Steve Gadd vibe.
Okay.
Where you've got the brushes and he's using the left foot on the hi-hat with some interesting little syncopation here and there.
Yeah. There was a part in there I was like, oh, he's getting a little loose there.
Yeah. 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 And it's a little quickie, but
yeah,
solid.
It's nice.
We're winding down the record.
We are.
We're at the end of side two.
Mm-hmm.
And you give us a little Sand Fairy Anne. After that, Must Do Something About It, you know. So good.
Yeah, we got one more track after this.
Speed of Sound.
You know, in yesterday's video, we were talking about...
The lovely artwork.
The Rival Sons record, yeah.
Because of Hypnosis.
Hypnosis, yeah.
Being an artist of note with regard to album covers.
In case you guys want to know, that's Pressure and Time is the album we're referring to. And I actually... we were talking about this off camera. I actually love the way that album looks.
Yeah, yeah. So there you go. And maybe some of you all love the way this looks.
Yeah. And I love the way this looks.
And you do. Yeah.
I do. I'm a big fan of Hypnosis, apparently.
Yeah. I am. I mean, come on. Like I said, Dark Side of the Moon, right? Yeah. Wish You Were Here.
Mm-hmm.
Epic.
Yeah.
But I like Led Zeppelin Presence.
But apparently you and Jay don't like Pressure and Time. So. Okay.
I like this.
Yeah.
And I love that.
Yeah.
That is freaking rad. You know, and as I pointed out in another video that we did for this record, you got to pull it out and get that version of it too.
Yeah, that's
really
cool.
They're putting it up on the marquee. It's so good.
That album is that's actually in really good shape.
I know, right? I bought this when I was a 13-year-old, 76.
This is the one you took back to the store and said, "This sucks."
Yeah, go rewind to the earlier one for the long story.
Yeah.
But the short story is, my 13-year-old ears were not ready for silly love songs.
Yeah,
and let them in. Having come from rock show and Jet and Band on the Run, I put this record on. I went and bought the new Paul McCartney, put it on at home, and was like, So I drove back to the record store and said, "I want my money back." And he wouldn't give me my money back, and so as a result, I have this very version still in my hands. And I'm grateful for that because I come to love it as I got older.
You know, speaking of that, Antoine, I asked the viewers on Wings Over America, I asked this dumb question, but it's kind of funny. So that song, Let Him In, every time I hear somebody knock on my front door,
yeah,
that song immediately comes into my head. Yeah, it immediately comes into my head.
Somebody knocking at the door.
My question to you is do you hear that song when somebody knocks at your door?
I may. Yeah, sure. I can't say that I've never thought the same.
I mean, silly. Yeah. You know.
You do the Maybe I'm Amazed band. You've been spending more time with Paul than I have in recent years. But yeah, that's definitely one of those songs.
You know, apparently I haven't been spending enough time with Paul.
Well, because,
I mean, I, you know, so here's a little backstory on how we started the band. I heard back in the U.S., like a couple years ago, I was on tour, and I was, you know, I've studied so much Beatles, right? Everything up till 69, 70, and hadn't really heard a whole lot of McCartney.
Wings.
Pretty much at all. So, I don't know why. I mean, my dad was a huge Beatles fan, a huge McCartney fan.
Huh.
They would go to McCartney shows all the time. I know we had records in the house. I know we had Back to the Egg. I know we had some other stuff. But we didn't really play it. He didn't really play it that much in the house. So I wasn't really exposed to it. But I was on tour, driving by myself. Like, I do these long drives back from the Midwest sometimes. So I put on Back in the U.S. because I'm like, oh, I want to hear something different, you know? So I put on Back in the U.S., which is, you know, not one of his well-known...
I don't even know it at all.
Yeah. Right. But it's like 2004.
Okay.
So, and I was just like blown away. It's blown away by the band, by, you know, all the music.
And
like,
who's in the band at this point?
It's the modern day band. It's Abel Boreal, Rusty Anderson, Brian Ray, and Wicks.
And that's the band that he stuck with.
I mean, Wicks has been with him since the 80s, but yeah, it's been his band for the past 25, 30 years, something like that. And just, you know, I love Rusty Anderson because I used to follow his band back in the 90s. They played around LA and stuff.
Yeah?
So yeah. Edna Swap. If you never heard Edna Swap, check that out.
Right on.
So, you know, I was listening to it and I was like, man, this would be an awesome show. Just like doing these songs, you know, like this sound. So I got, you know, that's kind of the approach we had when we created this band. So it's more of that.
That was the genesis of this. Maybe I'm Amazed. Yeah. Was you listening to that live record. Yeah. Which was a great band, or I guess is a great band. Yeah. If Paul's still at it.
Yeah.
I'm sure at one point he's.
Yeah, he's on tour right now, actually.
Oh my gosh, really?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, he's doing the Get Back tour again.
That guy.
Yeah.
That guy. So yeah, I worked with Paul. I was at Capitol Studios, late 90s, early aughts. And he came through there when he was doing the Run Devil Run record.
Okay.
Which is kind of, I don't remember it. Mm. You know what I mean? He basically was getting back to rock and roll. Mm. And he'd done some stuff in the 90s. And he came in there. And
that's the one with all the throwback stuff,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Yeah. So he was doing a bunch. And I think people were saying it had something to do with he had acquired Buddy Holly's publishing.
Okay.
So he wanted to do a bunch of Buddy Holly songs. Okay. And, he was doing a live record at the Paramount lot, which I've never heard, actually, now that I think about it. But they recorded it at the Paramount lot, brought it over to Capitol. They were mixing it. So he was in and out of Capitol for like 2 weeks while I was working there. And that was amazing. A lot of great stories in that. But the thing is that I remember thinking at the time, like, Paul, why are you making a new... You got so many songs. Why are you writing new songs?
Yeah.
Like, why do you keep making new records? Just give us the hits. And then it was only a couple of years later that he started doing that band.
Yeah.
And really did. And with Abe Laboriel Jr. drumming, like, that really had a lot to bring it together. Because some of those other bands, like, they didn't quite get the Paul thing, the Ringo thing.
Yeah.
Like, how do you get the Ringo thing and yet modernize it?
Yeah.
Like, they're either too modern or too 60s.
Yeah.
You know? And Abe's got that perfect combo of the two. So I can see where you would hear that album go, oh, okay, here's a show. What if we did this show?
Yeah, you know? I mean that's a major part of why I was attracted to it, is not only Rusty Anderson, but Abe.
Yeah.
Abe brings so much energy to a band.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I saw Abe, I think it was just a one-time thing, I'm not sure, but he was drumming for Sting, and they did that song Together, We'll Be Together, I think it's called. It was on, I want to say it was on Letterman. It was on one of those late-night talk shows. And just, I had never heard Sting with so much energy.
Yeah.
And I think that Sting hated it.
Yeah, it's too much.
Yeah, he's like, oh, no. Yeah.
You want to give me some of that?
Yeah. But it was so rocking. I was like, this guy is a monster. And, you know, Abe's around. He's around L.A. Yeah. Sometimes, you know.
Well, his dad was in Capitol a lot.
Yeah.
Abe Laboriel, his dad's a bass player. He was at Capitol a lot.
Yeah.
In fact, he gave us a bass lesson. For all you bass players out there, he gave us a bass lesson. He says, one of the guys asking, give me some tips. You know, give me something I can you know, pick up, walk away with. He goes, okay. He goes, you got a dollar? The guy's like, yeah, sure, I got a dollar.
Yeah.
Gives him a dollar. He's wearing a bass, right? Imagine I'm wearing the bass, right? Takes the dollar, and he sticks it in this between the strings, but then it falls down to the ground. He's like, oh, shoot. Picks it up. Puts it in between the strings a little further up the neck right here, right? Again, it falls out. He's like, man, I'm going to get this right. Hold on. And he puts it way up here, you know, up here on the neck. He puts it up on the neck in that first position. He puts the dollar, and it stays there. He's like, okay, great. Now I'm going to show you what. You see that there? That's where the money is. Bass players will get that. The musicians will get that. He's saying, keep it simple. Keep it simple.
Yeah. Yeah, way up high. First position. That's funny. Right on, man. Well, this has been fun. We've got one more track.
The last track on this
album. Yeah, the last track. What's it called?
Warm and Beautiful.
Warm and Beautiful, right. So this version says, sticking out of my...
What the...
Sticking out.
Did we lose a song on
no,
the?
No. It's Warm and Beautiful, but it says sticking out of my.
/ Warm and Beautiful.
Sticking
okay,
sticking out of my back.
We will find out tomorrow.
Oh, sticking out of my back pocket.
That says nothing warm about that here.
Okay.
I don't know anything about what you're talking about.
Well, we'll check that out tomorrow. Make sure you guys comment. Let us know your thoughts on all these things. We covered a lot in this video. We're having fun over here, so in case you didn't notice. So make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell so you'll know when we're coming out with the next video. And just like always, everybody, peace and love.
Peace.
goes.